Have you ever felt like you just felt really guilty about something and couldn't let it go? Last night, I was writing in my journal, as I often do, to finish my day, and I realized I had this really strong sense of guilt around something that had happened more than a year ago. So, those of you who've been journeying alongside me for a while might remember that early last year I went to Australia where my mum lives to spend some time with her. I wanted to feel close with her, and we had this really tumultuous relationship ever since my teens, probably even earlier. And I thought that, I believe that love can heal everything. And I thought that if I could love her enough, so that nothing else but love was left, we would have this beautiful, kindred, sweet mother-daughter relationship again. And unfortunately, it wasn't that way. It didn't turn out that way at all. And we went back into the same old patterns that I've experienced with her since I was really, really young. And, it's so easy to see when you're the other person. One of my mother's strongest and deepest patterns is her fear of rejection. She's so afraid that people will reject her in her life that she acts out in such a way and rejects the people that love her the most first. So she like gets in there before anyone else can to protect herself. And like we all have our stuff. So I love her. I really deeply love her. I'm just sharing this story because this is something that happened to me last night, or like in the last year. And so our relationship wasn't so great. And in her rejecting me, I couldn't, like, no matter how much I loved her and how much I told her I loved her and I tried to show her that I loved her, she would just put up walls and she would speak to me in ways that no one else speaks to me in, and it was really hurtful and it was a really challenging time for me. And I realized that it showed up one of my patterns that I've had for a long time, which was that I thought I could save people with love. And this pattern played out in my personal relationships for a long time until I became aware of it and I cleared it and it stopped, and that does not happen anymore. But then spending time with my mom, I realized I had this pattern originally with my relationship with her, and that I thought I could fix everything with love that I can't fix. You can never fix someone else. You can never heal someone else's hurt. That's their stuff. And I realized this and I was like, wow. So here's the pattern again. I found the source of it. I can clear it now. And in clearing it, I made a really, really challenging decision, and that decision was to stop having contact with her because it was really hurtful and harmful, and the things she was saying and doing, I would not allow anyone else in my life to do. Herein, we come back to what this video is about, which is clearing guilt. I felt so guilty for so long for making that decision because, as we all know, a good daughter doesn't say no to her mother or to someone she really, really, truly loves, especially a parent. And so essentially, I feel guilty because I felt like I was a bad person. And it wasn't until last night when I was journaling where it all came up and I was like, whoa, I'm carrying this guilt, which is so destructive and stopping me from feeling joy and love and happiness in other areas of my life because I'm still carrying it around. I'm still holding on to it, even though I made that decision from a space of love and connection and wanting everyone to be well and taken care of. And more than anything, as an act of self-love, of protecting myself and saying, no, this behavior is not acceptable for me from anyone. And so it ends here and breaking that pattern. And so I went through a process that I want to share with you today on how to free yourself from that guilt. And I do everything journaling, and I'm going to read out some of the parts that I wrote, but essentially it just starts with acknowledging the guilt. So I wrote out, whoa, this is what I feel guilty about, and this is why. So step one, acknowledge the guilt. Step two, write out why you feel guilty. It takes 3 minutes to do this and you are clear from guilt. Well, I am anyway, and I'm sure it works for everyone else if you're really, really honest with yourself. So one, step one, acknowledge the guilt. Step two, write out why you feel guilty. Step three, the most important part, decide that you're ready to let go of feeling guilty. And for me, I was like, yes, I understand why I feel guilty, because this choice isn't in alignment with how I truly want to live, but it's the best possible choice I could have made in that moment and in that circumstance, and it came from a space of love. Three, write out a positive statement on releasing guilt. And I'm going to read out what I wrote, which was, I am ready to set myself free of guilt. I let go of any sense of guilt to anyone about anything, because holding on to guilt is destructive and instead of being of service to me. I release my guilt into space and trust that I am guided to make good decisions for all involved from a space of love, connection, and wisdom. I am free of all guilt. And then simply you just need to trust that that intention is being realized, and know that because you've become really clear in yourself what the guilt is and why you felt it, and that it is not a valuable experience or a necessary lesson for you to hold on to the guilt, to be able to let it go. And this morning I woke up feeling amazing. I was like, wow, you know, I love my mother and that situation has been really difficult, and I understand the emotional process I've gone through with it, but it hasn't actually served a positive purpose for anyone, and I have learned my lesson, or I've learned several lessons from that situation, so it's time to move on and let go of the past. I hope this video helps you in your own processes in releasing guilt, and I would be so excited to hear what you have to say in your own experiences with guilt, especially around family members, because that's a huge topic.